Hey folks, in this video we're going to do the type of problem where we evaluate a trig function given a point on the terminal side of theta. And here's what I mean by that. You'll see these type of problems fairly frequently because you have to exercise a lot of trig knowledge in order to solve these. But it says, suppose an angle is in standard position such that the terminal side passes through the point -3, -4. Given that angle theta, evaluate sine, cosine, and tangent. Well, the first thing I like to do is I like to get a good look at these graphically. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to plot the point -3, -4, -1, 2, 3, 4. So I know my point is right here. So there would be the terminal side of the ray, and it says it's in standard position. So it's standard position, excuse me. So the initial side of the ray is there. And then this is our angle theta. Now, what we know is if we're evaluating sine, cosine, and tangent, we just got to think about what those mean. So we know that sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse, or we've redefined it on the coordinate plane as y over r. We know that cosine of theta is x over r, and we know that tan theta equals y over x, opposite over adjacent. Now, if we look at what we're given here, okay, our x is given to us. X is -3, and then our y is -4. So our x is -3, and our y is -4. So if we have those, we have almost everything we need. The only thing we're lacking, if we look at our trig ratios, we don't know r. We don't know the radius. Well, that would be this length right here. You could think of it as the hypotenuse to this little right triangle that we've constructed. So if I use my Pythagorean theorem here, and I'm going to skip the steps of that, you should get a 5. Keep in mind our radius, because it is a length, we're always going to consider it positive. Even though we're down here in the third quadrant, even though x and y are both negative, we're going to look at our radius as a positive value. So we have our x, our y, and our r. So based on that, we can just write our three trig equations. If sine of theta is y over r, that's going to be -4/5. Cosine is going to be -3/5. And then tangent y over x is going to be -4/-3. But tangent's positive down here because a negative over a negative is a positive. So our final simplified form of tangent would be 4/3. Now, often what you'll have with these type of problems is we're going to look at our second example in a minute, where our radius isn't such a nice, pretty integer value. It'll have a radical in it. So let's investigate that real quick. And so maybe do your best to pause this and try this one on your own if you think you know what's going on, and then hit play whenever you're ready. But suppose an angle is in standard position such that the terminal side passes through -4/2. So -4/+2. It looks like now we're kind of up here in this third quadrant, right? Second quadrant, I misspoke. And you got our initial side over there. So there is our angle in question for which we are defining our trig ratios. And we know that I've got this vertical value, this y value of 2, and this x, or this horizontal component, of -4. So if I have, you know, x is -4, y is +2, our r we would have to find. We'd have to do Pythagorean theorem. And this part I'm not going to skip just because this one doesn't end up giving us nice values. 4² = 16. 2² = 4. 16 + 4 = 20. So our radius is actually the root of 20. And if we simplify that radical, 20 is 4 times 5, and the square root of 4 is 2. Basically, I do all that to say that our r value, we could either do this next step using r as the root of 20, but I'm going to use it as 2√5 right here. So 2√5, and then once again, we always consider that radius as a positive value. Now, this one's going to involve a little more algebra to write our trig functions because we have the radical and because we're doing all six. So I'm going to list out all my trig functions real quick, and then we'll do the algebra for them. So let's start with our original three trig functions, and then we can come back and do the reciprocal functions in a little bit. But if I know that sine of theta is y over r, for this particular problem, that's going to be 2/√5. Well, the 2/2 can simplify. But then we got to rationalize this. I don't want to leave this in this form. I don't want to leave the radical in the denominator. So we multiply by root 5 over root 5. And our final form of this is going to be root 5 over 5, because 5 times 5 is 25, and the square root of 25 is 5. So that would be sine theta. Now let's do cosine theta real quick. Cosine of theta is going to be x over r, okay? That can simplify a little bit to be negative 2 over root of 5. But then once again, I'm multiplying by my fancy 1 of root 5 over root 5, and this is going to be negative 2 root 5 over 5, okay? Now, for tan theta, y over x, thank goodness, we don't have to deal with the radical. That one's just going to be negative 1 half. Now what we need to do, though, and I'm running out of room for this a little bit, we need to do our reciprocal function. So the reciprocal of sine theta is cosecant theta. The reciprocal of cosine theta is secant theta. And the reciprocal of tan theta is the cotangent of theta, which is just x over y. Now, what you might be tempted to do, since cosecant is the reciprocal of sine, is you might be tempted to just take this and then do the reciprocal of it. Say, oh, let's just do 5 over root 5, but then we have a few extra steps, because then you'd have to rationalize and get rid of that radical in the denominator there. What I propose instead is let's take this form, because this right here is equivalent to this. And if I take the reciprocal of this, we don't have to do any more simplifying. So I'm going to take that reciprocal, and it's just going to be root 5. So I just took that right there and did its reciprocal right there. Now let's do the same thing for secant. You might be tempted to take this form of our answer and find the reciprocal of it, but by taking the reciprocal of it, that root 5 goes in the denominator. And I think that's just going to provide a little bit of extra work. So let's just instead use this form of our cosine ratio. And so then when we do the reciprocal, that's just going to be negative root 5 over 2, okay? And once again, I got that by just taking this form of our answer and finding the reciprocal of it. And then lastly, cotangent is x over y. That part's easy. I can take this form of my answer if I want to and find the reciprocal. That's just going to be negative 2. So that is how you do it. Once again, these problems typically follow a certain structure. You're going to plot your point on a coordinate plane, use your Pythagorean theorem to find the r, and then you can just write out all your trig ratios from there. Don't forget to rationalize the denominator if need be. Good luck.